By God's graceful leading, our UBF ministry has been positioned as a potential powerful force for world mission in this generation. Campus evangelism targets a strategic demographic and is the backbone of our ministry. College students are the future leaders of each nation and society. American evangelist and the founder of CREW, Dr. Bill Bright, said, "If we win the campuses today, we will win the world tomorrow." The need for campus ministry is greater today than ever before. A strong case for this can be made just by examining the numbers. The current generation of college students is the largest since the baby boom, but the lowest percentage to grow up in church. More significant life choices, vocation, lifestyle, spiritual decisions, and relationships are made during college than any other stage of life. According to a 2004 U.S. research study, it was found that 77% of Americans who become Christians do so before the age of 21. From a worldly perspective, college is an independent institution of higher learning, offering a course of general studies leading to a bachelor's degree. But from Christ's viewpoint, college is a four-year window into a person's life when God has maximum opportunity to build a foundation into a life lived for Him. Second, God has positioned our church to do lay missions. A lay missionary is someone who works a full-time job and does mission work as well.
I left Korea with, I gave my prayer topic to the people. I'm so jealous, ambitious, and I pray that I may raise up one disciple of Jesus, one everyone faith within 2 years. I just flew to London, landed, here I am, your shepherd is coming, my sheep in England, that was my vision. And I was rejected all the time. My wife and we went there together for 2 years, talking to them, trying to get them to study the Bible. No fruit at all, no response for 2 years. And we got first the sheep, Ian, and he came to my house to study the Bible. And that was the beginning of the ministry. And he liked the Bible study. So, that's the beginning of disciple making.
The need for mobilizing lay missionaries for the expansion of the church has been emphasized by Christian scholars, including the English missiologist Roland Allen and the Dutch missiologist Hendrik Kramer, who called lay people God's frozen assets.
But professional missionaries cannot reach the some nations. But lay missionaries can go out all over the world, first thing. And second thing is that lay mission is the faith mission. They should carry out their job problem, study problem, language problem, and support problem. Lay missionaries can do all these things by faith, so that they can give good influence to native brothers and sisters.
I personally think that the term of lay mission is not correct, or the biblical term. The exact term is self-supporting missionaries. 2 Peter chapter 2 verse 9 also said, all Christians are royal priesthood. So every Christians are called by God as missionaries or preachers of the gospel. I think the most important thing is very simply rooted faith in Jesus Christ and also a passion of Jesus Christ. For this, we must study the Bible very personally and deeply.
Approximately 3.86 billion people, 53% of the world's population, are either completely unreached or unevangelized. Even if churches gave all of their money to missions, they could not support enough professional missionaries to reach this vast number of people. How can God's kingdom message break through, especially in nations where Christianity is not welcome? Based on these facts, how is the Holy Spirit leading His church to reach the unreached? Third, God has positioned UBF to be a cross-cultural church. Even though UBF has gone through hardships and growing pains while continuing to make disciples of all nations, we know that this is God's work because we see the same cycle displayed in the birth and growth of the early church.
When I arrived in Winnipeg, and our women co-workers were already there, and they were working and they're very busy studying English and Bibles and so on. I focused more on those commonalities rather than the differences. And so if I have to learn Canadian way, I tried to learn some Canadian way. And also while we were interacting, you know, in our relationship, we begin to learn from each other, right? And so they begin to eat kimchi, I begin to eat hamburgers.
God has used UBF greatly to expand His kingdom throughout the world, and His kingdom is also expanding within us, maturing us, pushing us deeper into the gospel, training us into a greater dependence on Him, and forcing us to go back to the Bible again and again. By God's grace, and in spite of ourselves, we are following the biblical call and pattern of building cross-cultural churches. Oh, come.